93.5 Red FM पर अंदिशा ओबेरॉय. दिस शो इज कॉल्ड मॉर्निंग नंबर वन. वी आर अबाउट 10 मिनट्स अवे फ्रॉम 9 o'clock ऑन अ थर्सडे मॉर्निंग एंड इन कॉन्वर्सेशन विद डॉक्टर शीतल चौरसिया, हु हैज बीन डीबंकिंग मिथ्स ऑन द वैक्सीन, इट्स प्रोसेस, इट्स साइड इफेक्ट्स, हु कैन टेक इट, हु कांट टेक इट. वी हैड लॉट्स ऑफ वॉइस नोट्स कमिंग इन ऑन 9880935935 एंड राइट नाउ आई हैव वन फ्रॉम पलक. लेट्स लिसन इन.
Hi Disha, this is Palak here. I have been hearing from social media and other platforms where it is said that one cannot consume alcohol for a few days after getting the COVID-19 vaccine. So is this true?
A question like this had to come up in the beer capital of the country. Palak, let's have Dr. Chaurasia take this question.
That is one of the main questions in the mind of everyone. It started because Russia gave an advisory to their people to not to consume alcohol before and after vaccination. There is no contraindication for drinking per se. Reason we are getting vaccinated is we want our immunity against COVID vaccine. And alcohol is known to be an immune suppressant. So that's the reason as a precaution we tell not to drink. Drinking in moderation I don't think is going to affect, but drinking anyway never advisable, but it's better a few days before and after if you don't consume alcohol, especially not in large quantities, to let the immune system be primed to produce antibody against COVID-19.
You know, I remember Palak mentioning he read a lot of stuff on social media. Dr. Chaurasia has something to say about that.
Ideally they should get the right information, definitely not in the social media. Where should they take it from? The official site. Mayo Clinic has a good site, or from the CDC, WHO, you know, the official, the government bodies, the medical journal or the medical site. There you can read about it. Twitter, WhatsApp, Facebook, they may not give you the correct data.
And Dr. Sheetal Chaurasia is with us debunking myths. 9880935935. Let's listen in.
Hi Disha, a very good morning to you. This is Jyotsna here. I was tested COVID positive 1.5 months ago and I recovered, but I'm not sure if I'm still eligible for the vaccine or not.
That's actually a good question, Jyotsna. Let's have Dr. Chaurasia answer it.
Patients who have active COVID should avoid COVID vaccination for at least 4 to 8 weeks post-COVID recovery. We have not tested them. I mean, vaccine is not something which is given in a patient who is actively having an infection. What we are recommending is 3 months post-recovery they can take the vaccine, because the primary infection also gives some amount of immunity.
Listen to a voice note that came in from Shreya. Let's check this out.
Good morning, Disha. This is Shreya here, and I was blessed with a baby boy 3.5 months ago. I'm very curious to know that can a new mom like myself take the COVID-19 vaccine? I'm also breastfeeding, so I also wanted to know, will the vaccine affect my breastfeeding journey? Thank you.
Shreya, we'll have Dr. Sheetal Chaurasia answer this.
Pregnant ladies, breastfeeding mothers should not take COVID vaccine because simply for the reason because they have not been tested in the trial for COVID vaccine. So we don't know what the vaccine will do to the baby or the mother or what effect it will have. So no, they are not advised to take. It's contraindicated.
You know, there's a lot of discussion about the vaccine being safe or not. Doc, what is your take on that?
There is a huge myth that it's not safe. The vaccine has not been tested properly and it has already in the market and being administered without the proper data. It's not entirely true. The vaccine has been fast-tracked, but that does not mean the steps have been skipped. It has undergone both phase 1, phase 2 and phase 3 trials as a routine. The volunteers have been tested. It has been found to be efficacious. It has been found to be safe. And that's the reason it's in the market. It's a pretty safe vaccine.
She says it's a safe vaccine. That is Dr. Sheetal Chaurasia. She's going to be 5 Andisha Oberoi, but jate raho.